I'm here again. I'm really not so nervous like when I'm a moderator. My name is Zhou. I've been working stability.
Actually,
we have removed the two words that is online.
Because
offline, you can do anything. Actually, we have not heard a lot about this topic. I want to give you two examples to quickly share with you about what this is about. If you know about the system delivery, it's just like when you buy a flat. You need to test the water pressure. You need to put the water pressure to the highest level to see whether there is water leakage. And for drill means whether you have any problems with your walls. You need to have professionals to identify the problems. You want to identify the problems but without breaking the wall. Second example is everyone will have vaccines.
The
second example is that everyone will have vaccines. So for your body, if you have some vaccines for your health, it will be helpful. So drill is like giving vaccines to your body. But how much you can get related to the question of that. And this is the agenda I'm going to talk about. First, I will talk about what does the drill consist of. Second, I'm going to share with you about some behind-the-scenes stories in Alibaba. And then I will talk about how failure injection testing background and realization, and then I will share with you on the cloud how can we provide such services to you. Previous two employees have already talked about the Alibaba's technical progression and what kind of problems would that bring. I want to focus more on the fault injection testing. If you are familiar with Alibaba's structure, you know that in 2009, there's a project which is called the Colorful Stone Project. And we have break down our applications. And for our architecture, it plays a very important role
in the evolution of our architecture. So there is a big change for the team construction and our businesses. For example, before we will together launch some products, but now we can have more internationalized business pattern, but it drops the cost of products. The first one is that because of this architecture, it will be highly distributed. Before, maybe one architect is very familiar with the total top architect and it's very easy for us to troubleshoot. Now, maybe you need to troubleshoot the whole link and it becomes much more complicated. And the second one is the vertical organizational structure. And before, we do not have those individual independent organizations, but now we have many of them. So before it was quite collective, but now it is quite fragmented and distributed. And in the end of 2011, there was a big incident. One of our very important PE level first stage platform, because of an error of a code in one of the iterations, it has caused a non-core service due to to an error, and the lower stream had an issue, so it caused the downtime of the whole service chain, and it was a very severe incident. And we decided to more scientifically and automatically manage architect, and we call it the strong and weak dependence. And we need to solve the problem of the stability when we have a complicated architect and who has laid a foundation for the failure rehearsal. And we have also advanced a lot of technologies later on. Of course, it's not a key for my instruction today. But later, in 2014, we made several attempts. The first one is it possible for us to move the offline rehearsal to online? And the second is what kind of new solutions could we provide to make the checks? And in 2016, inside Taobao, we have a very large scale rehearsals. We have conducted hundreds of rehearsals, and there were some PE-level breakdowns. And in the peak time of the Double 11, it was a very exciting moment for us to check the technologies. We have been preparing for the technologies for a whole year, and then in that day, we could check whether it's supportive enough or not. And there were a lot of small details that would affect the status of the final system. So this is the background introduction, and this one, this is the total picture of the high availability of a company. We not only have the failure rehearsal as a tool, it's also a solution, as I said, that you need to find out the best way to do it. And I have made a commitment at the very beginning that I want to tell you some anecdotes of it. So these anecdotes does not have any timelines, so in total, we have a lot of different failures and faults, but we could categorize them into four dimensions. The first dimension I had also touched upon it a little bit before. We have a very distributed system, and as it differs, the dependence on the lower stream. How dependent are you on the disaster recovery of the lower stream? As I have mentioned, we have the online systems that can automatically isolated itself from the lower streams. And how can you do that is you need to think about another issue. Maybe you have ignored it sometimes. For example, the whole link is of a very high availability. But one of the most important things is that you have the tool systems. For example, before you have this case, if this is a large event, and suddenly you realize that the monitoring system is not accessible, then it's not important for you to treat this program because you do not know where does the problem come from. And we have encountered this kind of situation before because of the server error in the backstage. The whole tool system goes down. And once there is a problem, and you could not identify a person who was accountable for it. For example, there is a shift of duty, and you cannot find the responsible person. And sometimes some figures will play a very important role in the stability of the system, and there will have the retention issues of the employees, but not all of the employees grow up in a lot of failures. And they need a lot of practices to accumulate experiences. It's just like the vaccines people need to inject. We need to create troubles for ourselves so that our immune systems can be stronger. And we have listed some abstract information here. We have reflected on the failures we could deal with, and hope that there is a solution that can improve the accountability of the people and the tools. But there is a core factor here that is it should be controllable, real enough, and beneficial for enough. So I'd like to briefly introduce those tests and chaos engineering. In failure rate also, at least in China, it is a niche market. It's not like perfect control or limitation. You still have very limited understanding of failure, but in overseas market, it's already very well developed. So you may heard of many names such as Chaos Monkey. They will promote this very often. So in China, I want to advocate as well. That's why I want to have deep instructions about it. So it's not a new concept. So locally, when I cut down the power of the hard disk, it's also kind of it. But this is a standardized test procedure. And at the very beginning, NASA already has a special team developing this solution. Before we have encountered a failure, and in NASA they have made a lot of tests, and they didn't do a boundary test in extreme condition because they believe that this will not happen in real world, but in the end it has happened. So this theory has been proposed for a very long time. We did not have a large scale communication or promotion, but in 2012, he open sourced the Chaos Monkey. Why did he want to do that? He does not want to be a hero. Instead, he has migrated the whole architecture on Amazon, but Amazon had a failure. And, the system was down for a very long time, so he said that I do not trust you. And at a software level, we have to do it. So all of the ecosystem will cause some troubles through Chaos Monkey. And they have tried everything to advocate this culture. And that's why when they are faced with some of the large failures, they can recover in a very short term. It's not important what kind of tools you use. It's important that you need to know the importance of chaos engineering. So I have introduced the background now. So why do we call it the failure rehearsal? Maybe the initial purpose for us to do so is quite different from previous people I mentioned. I'd like to start from four factors. And I mentioned we hope that the historical failures can have a very big value for us, and we hope that the stability could be improved, and the architecture can have a better understanding of the problems. Once there is a point has a fault, then we should roll out this solution to the whole link, and there are five core features of failure rehearsal. And later on, I will also introduce these features when I'm talking about the technical solutions. The first one is that we are doing the failure injection at the software level. We will not unplug the machine. We will not cut off the power because we focus on the software levels, and we will interrupt the software and maybe between OS and the application layer. In the middle layer, we would inject some of the problems, and we will not unplug the network. So first of all, this is a software layer failure injection, and secondly, we have covered all of the frequently seen scenarios. The third feature is also very key, and sometimes we will face a lot of business pressures, and we do not have the time to root cause for those failures. So we have used a plug-in, plug-out program. And the fourth feature is also of interest of a lot of people, that is this rehearsal scenario is quite controllable. And the fifth one is that we have a control board to help you to conduct the whole rehearsal procedure. On this slide, you can see a simplified model for the systematic practice. And under this model, we have sorted out a large amount of the failures. No matter it's a dependent failure or it's a machine failure, there are several dimensions. The first one is that it's caused by hardware. The second one is that it's caused by the courses. And the third one is that it's caused by the non-process issues. So in this platform, there's a key area. The first one is that we provide the two plugins. And the more frequently used plugin is related to Java, and we will revise the code on the application to enhance the application. And in the third-party realization, we can create such a failure. And it will solve the problem of the process-related errors. And the second one is the non-process related faults, and it's not related to the process. With these two types of plugins, we could cover most of the failures, and we also have some of the other failures. For example, how can we create failures by ourselves? And for this, we have provided a standard API method. We also have some of the third-party systems to allow us to do that, and by doing so, the central server could manage the whole procedure of a failure rehearsal. And our target is that we will make a default of the accumulation of historic failure, and we will accumulate those failure cases into a library of failure cases. And the core of the rehearsal as I have mentioned, we have the failures from the processes and out of the process. For the failures out of the process can be categorized into several groups. The first one is that due to a lot of the reasons, there is a latency for the external exchanges, and most of it is caused by the network. And for some of the other reasons, there is a completion of the resources or compete to get the resources, and there is some chaos of the data. And we have designed a software, an OS plugin, to default that we could get into all of the application machines. And when there is an external request for the interaction, then it will inject a problem. And there are two types of the process related faults as well. The most frequently seen fault is that at the lower stream, maybe we will have a down time of the system. And there will be a latency. And the second type is that the business code is wrongly written and there is an error engendered any access. So you would inject the cutoff or the latencies. So it seems very simple, but in the whole process of evolution, the most important feature is that every application is self-centered. For example, you have called 100 services. You do not need these 100 services to go around to you. And before the core of the services, you have already injected this code, and we use the plugins to write the failure in advance.
The switching of the threads or occupation of the memory, or if just returns an error. So for the key principles are here for the fault injection. And this is what we have talked with you in the beginning. So we definitely believe this fault injection testing has covered all the problems. If you want to make a comparison with some open source technology, is all there. So I have said that this is what you can do online. So and we can also do that according to the business characteristic. And it will only impact something with the characteristics. So you can do that in the production environment. You're not limited to the environment. and you don't need to make any changes. Here is some of our internal practices. The previous speaker has talked about full link stress test. You might also have thought about some of the problems were only encountered at high stress, and some problems can be encountered not at high stress. So we have different dimensions. So according to different characteristics, we can have a different testing plans. It's just like a vaccination. So we need to test if I simulate the downtime, if you can find that, and if you have a new structure that will launch, I want to see whether the disaster recovery is okay. So the whole thing can be reflected to every corner. So how are we going to do that? That is the solution. Now, we are only providing the capability. Architects or professionals need to do that. Our experiences, our standard things can be accumulated, and we can follow up on that. And here we also want to say, for those who are doing the stability, when you are doing the assurance, you will believe the stability is difficult to grasp, and you need to have a standardized decision-making brain, which will be responsible to making the right decisions about the operations. But we have so many issues, so many factors that can lead to some issues. So we believe that some of the problems can be defaulted for automated settlement through some components. We have an KGR, that is the fault tolerance. The difference from conventional one is the prompt feedback. Maybe after 6 years, your SLA has not been reached. But with this model, you can immediately test after each iteration whether the thresholds has been fulfilled. So in the default middleware, at the middleware level, we are testing KGR. Here, I want to give you a brief interview. We go from four levels of severity. Most of you will focus on going to the bottom. And some of you will say that our data has already achieved high availability. Our system will have a high availability. So the occupants of the resources can slow down your service, but you need to ensure the service provided are correct. The correctness is the most important requirement for the first requirement. You have to ensure the service is correct. Second, when you identify some damages caused by force majeure, you need to control the fault to a specific level. So you cannot be this or that, and the other things should be okay. And the third one is you often neglect. Maybe for the application itself, you need to rely on a lot of external data. I want to ask you a question. When you want to get an M page, if there's delayed and deleted, will that be still okay? We haven't focused on that. But a lot of failures have told us this is also very important. Last one is under high traffic, we need to protect ourselves, and we can have a quick cutoff, and or we can also transfer the traffic to other servers for the Alice middleware. We are focusing on these four dimensions to test the software quality. Later, we are going to expand this standard so that any applications assessment can adopt this model. The final part is we are providing high availability assessment services. So if we tell them that we're going to help them to do a high availability assessment test, normally we would believe that the customers have high requirements for high availability, and we don't have a dedicated team for high availability. They don't have so many, and they also don't have sufficient problems for them to develop on their own. So we bring a lot of scenarios in Ali's ecosystem. A lot of faults you haven't expected. We extract that and we combine that with the KGR model. For any application, we can provide a professional assessment service. So at a low cost, it can help you to identify an issue. And for our products, the advantage has been mentioned earlier. The first one is about the full data. There will be continuous supply of the full data. Second is reliable. Actually, this plan has been verified during Double 11 for some common third-party framework, so you can feel confident to use this. The third one is about the ecosystem. We have mentioned that for the high availability, it's not that you should be okay after you have done the testing. If you have any problem, how are you going to repair that? You need to do the testing, stress test, etc. So we are going to connect all with other high availability products and provide it to our customers as in the format of assessment. I don't know how many of you know it does. It's a PaaS platform under Aliware. Now in EDAS, we incubate that as middleware. For this plan, no matter in the process or out of the process, right now it's in Java, you don't have any dependence. So you don't necessarily to use a specific technical stack. You can also use other common stacks, and you don't need to do any modifications. In EDAS, you can use your testing template, and you will be able to see your reports. So it is a closed loop for the high availability. If you are interested, you can scan the QR code, which is my Dingding account. You can have more in-depth communication with me. That's all for my presentation. If you are interested, you can have a communication with our colleagues over there. Thank you.
I'm
still nervous. Next, I'm going to have a survey. How many of you have heard about offsite active before you come to this session? So I think I will need to introduce that. So we will have a seasoned colleague who is a responsible person for offsite active. He's going to share with us about the offsite active deficit.